privilege of meeting David Gluckman a few weeks ago. And I suddenly discovered that although I'm in the business of transforming people's lives, what I do is very similar to what David does. Now, he is in the business of innovation, and it may not be a name that is particularly familiar to you, but I think you will know something about the product or one of the products that he has produced. Let me tell you a little bit more about David. He was born in South Africa in 1938, and as a young man, he moved to London and started his innovation in London. You will probably recognize one of the brands that he created, and that's Kerrygold. In 1973, he was asked by an Irish company to come up with a new idea for a drink. And he thought, well, I had such a good time when I was working with Kerrygold. It would be nice to bring something from the dairy side of the industry into this product. So he had this idea. Cream, he thought. Now, if I mixed this cream with Jameson's whiskey, perhaps that could actually be quite a nice drink. So he and his business partner tested that and thought, gosh, this is surprisingly good. But maybe what it needs is a little bit more sugar. So they added sugar to it. And it looked and tasted, well, it actually tasted really very good, but there was something missing. So they went back to the supermarket and found Cadbury's drinking chocolate. When they added this to their product, they realized they had something very special. Now, all of that, from the moment the concept of that idea to actually producing that drink, was only an hour of their time. But what they then needed to do was all the R&D in a lab in Harlow. They had to go and find a bottle that they could put this product in. There was all the things around the logo and everything else. And the other thing was that they needed to come up with a name. And that became the most difficult thing of all. Until one day they realized that actually their offices was very close to a bistro called, have you guessed it? Bailey's. So they came up with the idea of calling this brand Bailey's. They then had to do a bit of the market research. They took the product and shared it with a few men who thought it was a rather girly product, but actually tasted quite good. The ladies, however, again, they quite liked it, but they thought it looked a bit like, you know, that stuff called kaolin and morphine that was good for diarrhea. He seemed to have a lot about that tonight. Anyhow, they thought that it was okay. What was interesting was when the product was actually put into a pub, two bottles on the shelf, and it just sat there. And David thought, maybe it's not such a good idea. Until one day he went into the pub and he found that actually one of the bottles had disappeared. When he asked the landlord about it, he said, oh, actually two policemen had come in and they completely devoured the whole bottle between the two of them. At that point, he decided this was actually a product that was worth taking to the client in Dublin. So off he went with a brilliant presentation, and he took his product to Gilby's, it was the name of the company in those days. And Gilby's thanked him for the product, gave him his £3,000, and off he went. So where is that product now? Well, let me tell you that in 2007, what actually happened was that there were 120 million bottles of Baileys being sold across the world. And it is now the biggest liqueur that's sold, the biggest product around the world. So where does that link with me? Well, the thing is that David kept the brief very simple. When I work with my clients, I like to keep everything simple so that we can both understand each other. David actually likes to make sure that whatever he does, he provides an excellent product and is different. And I certainly choose to be very different in the way I work with my clients. And the third thing is that when I'm working with a client, I trust my own instincts. And I think about what is being said to me from my client. And you know what? David Gluckman also trusts his own instincts. Because if he'd only gone with that market research, we may never have had this bottle called Baileys, which is so similar to how it was in 1973 when he first came up with that idea. Thank you.